the culture at Carroll is such that it just brings out the best in you. They're so friendly, and that's the experience I had immediately as a student, and that just throughout the 4 years I was there, it just created a better me when I graduated.
Jack found his niche there, and he believes in the mission of Carroll.
I met Diane, my wife, at Carroll, and then we got married, raising a young family, and I just was not real active at school at Carroll at that time until I was asked to be on the alumni council. That was about 15 years ago.
Diane brought up a word and she was describing it. She said it's an African word. And I knew exactly which one she was talking about. It's called Ubuntu. And it is that quality that in a person that makes him exude compassion and caring and love of all humanity. And that really describes Jack.
Our freshman year, Howard Fuller was a classmate of mine. We were both freshmen together. He was president. I was vice president of the freshman class. While I was at Carroll, I was active with my fraternity brothers, the Betas. That was a big part of my social life at the time.
It's obvious that he has like this belief in service to others. And I think it's a reflection of his community work that he's done around his church. I mean, there's so many things.
There's no job that's too small, too big. He's very humble about what he is willing to do, anything. From Buckthorn to the food pantry, he was sorting food, to moving the kids in the dorms.
That just brought me into Carroll in a deeper way, because then I became active in the things that the Alumni Council was involved in, and that just really enhanced my impression of Carroll being a friendly place. It hasn't changed. It's even though Carroll's gotten bigger population-wise, the same type of culture continues to exist there.
When we have lunch, it's just that he'll mention some of the things that he's engaged in, and it's almost always about helping others. And so I think that he clearly has that as a part of his makeup and as a part of him as a human being.
About 4 or 5 years after I was on the council, Blaine Dexheimer left. He was the chair of the Alumni Council. He left, and they asked me to be the chair of the Alumni Council, which put me on the Board of Trustees, which really made it interesting. When I was on the Board of Trustees, too, the one thing we took on was the Harris Building. And that was, we were raising money for that project at the time.
He knows everybody. He remembers. This man can remember names from years ago. And that's good for Carroll to have somebody like that talking about the alumni and what they're doing now, what their successes are. He's always pumped up about Carroll.
Since Carroll, I think I've been part of the, one of the people that's helped organize the class reunions. And Diane has done the same with her class, which is 2 years later than mine.
He's like the goodwill ambassador of Carroll. You know, any function that we go to that he's at, he has to be the person who goes around the room. Diane never knows where he is because he's off making a new friend and welcoming people back to school. It's just a gift.
Carroll should be very proud to have a man of such integrity, you know, serving them and inspiring other students and other graduates to a higher level of living, not always serving yourself, but serving others.
Well, it's very much an honor, but it's, in light of what MacAllister PE did for Carroll, it's hard to really have that sink in and realize how special that is. And I feel that part of this award should go back to the people that have really helped me through the process. I think it's all a matter of people helping people, and it's not just one person's contributions, but it's all kind of a togetherness thing.